Mission Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine McLaurin. The first of three October spacewalks took place this week. NASA astronauts Randy Bresnik and Mark Vandehei spent several hours working in the vacuum of space on Thursday. After getting suited up and out the door, the duo went right to work on their primary task, replacing one of two latching end effectors on the station's robotic arm, Canada Arm 2. This is the part of the arm that grabs onto things from visiting spacecraft to the space station itself. The next two spacewalks are coming up on October 10th and 18th, and will be focused on lubricating the newly installed end effector and installing new high-definition cameras on the outside of station. And it's growing season once again aboard the space station. The crew just recently set up a new batch of seeds for the ongoing veggie experiment, which looks to expand our ability to grow fresh food in space, potentially supplementing the diets of long-duration crews. This will be the first time a variety of crops will be grown simultaneously. The crew routinely tended to the plants throughout the week and will look to harvest in a few weeks. This week's Twitter question comes from Bob Rapp, who wanted to know how many airlocks are on station. Right now there are three, with some significant differences in how they're used. There are two airlocks available for spacewalking humans right now on station, the Quest airlock on the US side and the Pirs airlock on the Russian segment. A third airlock is located in the Japanese Kibo module and is used to move payloads bound for the vacuum of space. Keep sending us your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.